So in this video, I'm going to show you how to destroy a 3D game object in Unity by using Collider. So it's pretty much simple. So I have a currently my game screen over here. It doesn't touch pretty much anything, and it's just a ball and ground at a ground. So let me play it and show it to you. So it's just rotating on the ground. So I have a script attached to the sphere over here. So sphere is my player. It's the football right there, and this is the script and it's a rigid body, and I have attached a star to it and order transfer rotate. This makes it to rotate when it falls on the ground. So okay, so let's get to the point. And in order to first enable collider, first you need to go to sphere. Okay, and you need to check whether the sphere collider is enabled. So suppose if it is a rectangle or cube or a cuboid, I'm going to show you need to add box collider. So first condition for doing this collider or destroying this, first both the objects that are going to collide need to have a collider. So what collider basically does is it detects the collision on the surface. Okay, so that's pretty much that's this task. And if you haven't added box collider, just go to add component and search sphere or box collider and just add it over there. That's it. So already added it, so let me take it. So let me remove it. Okay, I've added already. So and yeah, box code is over here, and is trigger is not added because we're not going to use is trigger, we are going to use only collider. So okay, so both should have collider first. Next thing, next we are going to detect this collision by using tag. So many would do by different ways, but I am you're going to use this by tagging. I think tagging is more easy and understandable. So for tagging, first just double click on the object. I am double click on the football, and you need to just go to this tag option over here. Just below the name of the 3D object and tag, and already it will have a bunch of tags. But if you want to name your tag preferably or manually, just go to add tag and just click this plus and give your favorite name. I will give you football. Actually my tag name was player. Okay, I will change it. New tag, just type and save it. Okay, now we have added the tag, and just come out of this, just close tab. And now if you double click sphere and just go to this here and go to add tab and go to inspector, and see that's the same thing, I've closed it. So now if you go under this tag, we would have added the football gets tag gets added. So tag helps us to uniquely identify each and every game object or 3D object present in our Unity game. And for cube, I have added this as ground. Okay, so both should be different, that's the main thing I'm saying. So that's it. So that's the work on Unity workspace. So next thing, the code. So just open the code that you have done for your sphere. You can attach the script also to your cube or ground or even to this player. So that's not going to matter. That's the code, how that's manipulated, that's going to decide what you need to perform. So just go to sphere and I attach this new behavior script over here. So this is the script that I've attached to my football. So it doesn't have anything, just a start and update. So now the important thing is, we're going to use on collision enter. So that's the name of the function. That's an inbuilt function. We're not going to declare it. So it's going to be on collision enter. Okay, just on collision enter, just click it and it will automatically create everything for you. And the variable name is collision. Okay, and this is data type. So that's it. So using this collision, we will be able to access both the 3D game objects. And now we are just going to write the condition, what will happen if collided. So basically the main thing that Unity gamers do while doing this collision is for destruction, I think. So when a player collides with the obstacle gets destroyed, or when the player gets collided with the enemy, both the player and enemy gets destroyed. So that's, I think, the main function of this destroying or collision. So let me do the demo for that. That's easy understandable. So just go to the if condition. If collision dot, so collision corresponds to basically the player. Okay, collision is a reference to the player or the thing that we have to the 3D object that we attached to our script. So that's more generic. So collision dot, if collision dot game object equals game object dot tag. Okay, tag equals, so we're asking if our player game object is collided with the game object of a tag ground. Okay, so here Where I'm using ground is the base that I have used for the football is a ground one, ground tag. So I am using tag as ground. So inside this, just click destroy. And inside the destroy, we are just going to pass parameters. So first one, so inside destroy, just type collision dot game object. Okay, and just click enter. Okay. So now let me save it, and you will understand this code when I run it now. So you can see here. Loading. And now if I play it, you can see here. So that collision.game object referred to the ground base that I had. So now what if I wanted to destroy both the football and the player and the ground? Just you need to include the function destroy this dot game object. So this will this corresponds to the player and this corresponds to the object that is gets loaded with the play. So let me save it, and if I run it, both the things will get destroyed, vanished. Yes, that's it. So this is how collision and collider works, and you need to be more specific with this conditions over here. So collider, I have east trigger is not there, and I have used gravity. That's things also comes about to it. And that's it. Thanks for watching, and I've done many other tutorials in Unity and other programming languages like Python, and just check it out, and thanks for watching.